explicitly, it's not our job to relocate it.
Yeah.
If there's something we pick up, we pass it back to them, let them resolve the issue.
Yeah.
And then it'll be accepted from there on. James, I'm going to move on.
Just looking at page 237, I noticed that the budgeted use of reserves for adult subject care we want to budget at 6 million for that. I'm wondering if it's a specific project which has cost that much, because otherwise it looks like we've got 2 million left. So do you know what that 6 million budget is lining for?
Specific reserves for projects, the national, it's not the national minimum, that's picked up elsewhere, but it's for agreed projects, so projects don't run, ideally between March and the following, sorry, from April to the following March. So obviously, when programmes go over into the other year, we put money aside to cover those. So it will be related to a specific projects. A lot of it will be with health.
Charter, but as I said,
facing as and when new legislation flows through. Questions?
Any questions?
Why do we have other policies and investing in other policies? You know, if we're going to do an internal audit, why are you saying we're set to come and do an internal audit? So that, you know, it would be kosher.
Yes.
You know, I'm not to spark Jim, but you know, you want to answer that, didn't you?
Yeah, what was it? I think I mentioned, I presented a report about 4 months ago, I think, regarding a peer review. So every local authority in the UK will be peer reviewed by another local authority, and actually ours, Liverpool City Council's internal audit service is being peer reviewed next month by Glasgow City Council. As I said, it's companies in the UK, and in November, Liverpool City Council's internal audit service are peer reviewing Manchester City Council. So
my to move. Some of them can be social care files, and to be honest, if you deal with social care, some of the files can be three boxes, and some people are dealing at times with like one subject access request in 1 week. Again, some of the other initiatives to be aware of, moving to a system called Egress Switch, which is a secure email encrypted solution between ourselves and Hotmail accounts. And for the people we sent it to, I'll use numbers as an example here, you'll have the Liverpool.government account, our internal network, which is firewalled. If you're sending emails to your Hotmail account, it's not secure. If you send it by Egress Switch, you have to put a password back, it costs you nothing. And then that communication between those two pieces of machinery is then encrypted. It's called Friends of Egress. So I do quite a campaign to go out to various organisations and partners we deal with to move to Egress Switch. Maybe sadly supported a lot of our big Merseyside partners also on the road this year. Just a couple of final points. It makes it quite clear in terms of the amount of training that goes on that whole field of information and data protection. I did a session last year for well over 1,000 staff. Every month we have a drop-in session, it's always about 10 between 30 and 40 staff, on mostly on data protection, some freedom of information. But it's now mandatory for every member of staff, that's been for a while, to ensure they're trained on data protection. Your two biggest strategies for an organisation are your people management strategy and your data management strategy. I think the report outlines some of the key areas of the way the framework in which you operate. And the last point I'll comment on is everything's changing. We're going to have new data regulations, what we're having Brexit. The European regulation came out in the middle of this year, around February or March. We're supposed to have new legislation by 2018. We'll have to have something that's quite similar. The fines, which are currently £500,000 from the ICO, will go to £2 million, or 2% of your turnover. And there's a whole host of other things within the new regulations. It's one of the top pieces of legislation in the Brexit that's been talked about. So it's a case of watch this space. But some of the things we are doing, like even this report in publicly to a select committee, questions to be asked, is part of the new regulations. This other thing around data assurances from key staff is a part. So we're trying to work ahead of the game moving forward. And I'm happy to take questions here.
This has always been a happy chat, and it's nice to see you. I'll just point out before you answer that, Hilary Port does say that simple query can cost you £164 or something. But if it goes past the simple query and goes to the tribunal, an individual tribunal can cost you £10,000 in time and effort in the information. And as Chris mentioned, it's cost us present £300,000 a year. So it's not expensive, but it has to be done. Any further questions?
Thanks, Joe. Just on page 269 on the roles and responsibilities.
councillors.